Good evening, church. Happy Sunday evening to you. I want to greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. An early Merry Christmas to you all. Folks, just a quick testimony. Our choir, our children, under the leadership of Hannah Spataro, they have been working, we have been praying, and you will truly, truly be blessed this evening. A wonderful way in which we can usher in the birth of Jesus Christ and give him all of the honor and the glory. So what a witness they will be for all of us this evening. Let me pray over us, please, and then we will begin our production. Let us go to the Lord. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, O God, it's moments like this where we can sing from the heart, Lord, where we can have deep faith in knowing that Jesus is alive and that he is coming once again into the Bethlehem of our own hearts. I pray that we receive him this evening through the witness of our choir, through the gifts of our children, under the leadership of Hannah. Lord, they have been working diligently and we have been praying them through, Lord, their practice, Lord, and their love for you. So bless this evening, Lord. Be with the choir, be with the children, be with every person involved, Lord. It truly takes a village in order to make such a production happen, but we do it, oh God, for your glory. So bless this evening from start to finish, and by the end of this evening, Lord, your name will be lifted on high, and to you always be the glory. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen and amen. Enjoy.
Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Darkness of the night.
In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said,
Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be given the throne of his father David, and reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end.
How will this be, since I am a virgin?
The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she was said to unable to conceive is in her sixth month. No word from God will ever fail.
I'm the Lord's servant. May your word to me be fulfilled.
Then the angel left.
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters?
Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you?
Child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand?
Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels tried? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Your baby boy is Lord of all creation.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nation?
Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's power?
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee in Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in swaddling and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people here in the town of David. A Savior has been born to you. He is Messiah. He is the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest heavens, and on earth peace to whom his favor rests."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing happen, which the Lord has told us about."
Yeah. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Thank you so much, everyone, for coming out. Let's give another big hand to all the people who made this show happen, the choir, the bell choir, and the drama.